It is often said, ladies and gentlemen, that we all across the world, whatever our age or experience or status is, if you have read a book called The Alchemist, that states that if you truly wish something from the heart, it comes true. We all, ladies and gentlemen, in this very August gathering, have been in pursuit of a dream which many say never come true. But if you have seen a movie called Pursuit of Happiness, if you haven't, I would heartily request you to see it. Most probably you have, which says that life is nothing but a pursuit of dreams. On this wonderful thought, ladies and gentlemen, I'm Pallab Bose, your man on the microphone here this evening. Gives me a tremendous amount of honor and pride to be in front of such an audience, August gathering, to welcome you to the G-Files Governance Awards 2012. The galaxy of stars, ladies and gentlemen, we've had the opportunity to be blessed by them at every occasion. They're youth icons. It's led by, if you could, from your heart, put a big round of applause to welcome our galaxy of stars. Let's hear it from you, ladies and gentlemen. Honorable Union Minister for External Affairs, Mr. Salman Khurshid, our chief guest. Our esteemed guest of honor for the evening, ladies and gentlemen, include Chairman NTPC, Mr. Arup Roy Chaudhary. Chairman ONGC, Mr. Sudhir Vasudeva. Chairman EPI, Mr. SPS Bakshi. And Chairman HAL, Mr. RK Tyagi, and our jury members for the Governance Awards. Welcome, and from the heart, a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. I wouldn't take too much time, but just a very small introduction to the program. There are two things happening, ladies and gentlemen. One, the first ever historic G-Files Governance Awards that shall be given away to the awardees. And secondly, these awards coincide with the fifth anniversary of the G-Files magazine. Ever since times immemorial, there have been a positive correlation between communication and good governance. The media not only acts as a watchdog power, but has a role to play in ensuring good governance. It gives me and all of us at G-Files a great pleasure to welcome you on behalf of a magazine on governance and bureaucracy. That's G-Files, ladies and gentlemen. G-Files is India's first highly read and reputed monthly, read by the people who shape public policy and India's destiny. What makes G-Files truly extraordinary is the fact that it provides a platform for people who matter, the decision makers, many of whom are seated here, whose administrative initiatives leave a lasting impact on the lives of the Indian masses. This was a journey, a very humble journey, ladies and gentlemen, which started 5 years ago. Started by former India Today editor Inderjeet Badwar, former political editor of Jain Television, Mr. Anil Tyagi, and Dr. G.S. Sood, a well-known financial expert. Those were the days when there was no publication catering to this vast audience base. G-Files, ladies and gentlemen, not only filled the void, but has developed into a powerful medium of communication. A medium that informs, inspires, motivates, and boosts the moral of civil servants, bureaucrats, public sector employees and policy makers, think tanks and the bankers, and gives them a wholesome read, things that you normally don't get anywhere else in the print, electronic or the web media today. I take this opportunity, ladies and gentlemen, to invite our very esteemed guests for inaugurating the Governance Awards for the lamp lighting. I would request Mr. Anil Tyagi and Dr. G.S. Sood of G-Files to escort our esteemed guests to the lamp lighting ceremony. Please join us, ladies and gentlemen, as I invite our esteemed gathering to the lamp lighting. Honorable Union Minister for External Affairs, Mr. Salman Khurshid. Yeah, keep your claps going. Yeah, thank you. Chairman NTPC, Mr. Arup Roy Chaudhary. Chairman ONGC, Mr. Sudhir Vasudeva. Chairman EPI, Mr. SPS Bakshi. Chairman HAL, Mr. RK Tyagi. None other than the very dynamic bureaucrat, Mr. Prabhat Kumar, former Cabinet Secretary of India. Former Secretary PAR, Mr. Anil Razdan. Former Chief Secretary of Haryana Government, Mr. Vishnu Bhagwan. Former Secretary Internal Security, MB Kaushal. And CMD of IDBI Bank, Mr. RM Malla. And all of you, ladies and gentlemen, please join us for the lamp lighting ceremony. A very august gathering, ladies and gentlemen, as you can see. Many friends meeting, and it's happy times and celebration time at the Governance Awards. With the blessings of the Almighty, for wonderful governance as we move into the new year, 2013, very soon, is basically the celebration of the season. And greetings coming in from the G-Files team. Thank you, gentlemen. May I request the team at this loud and sound console to switch off the lights, as I would request all of you and your attention for just a few minutes on the audiovisual screens, as we shall play a wonderful corporate film that talks about the wonderful journey of G-Files and its indulgence. We shall be right back.
Matter who you are. What matters is what you can do. It doesn't matter how lofty your dreams are. What matters is how much you believe in them. It doesn't matter how many goals you reach. What matters is how you can make a big difference in the small world around you. Dreams are infectious, but still, only some fructify. 5 years ago, G-Files emerged as the brainchild of Inderjeet Badwar, Anil Tyagi, and Dr. G.S. Sood. The vision was to create a monthly magazine on governance and bureaucracy. This was a daring challenge, as there was no publication catering to this vast audience base of people who run the growth engine of governance in India. G-Files is India's first highly read and reputed monthly magazine, focusing on the power plays of governance and bureaucracy that shapes public policy and India's destiny as the world's fastest growing global power. A platform for people who matter, the decision makers whose administrative initiatives shape the opinion of the masses and leave a lasting impact on private, public and international lobbies. G-Files gives an exclusive insight into virtually everything that civil servants, executives and public sector enterprises, thinkers and policy makers, business and financial analysts, corporate bigwigs and experts on socio-economic politics and legal matters want or need to know. It has now become a barometer that reflects the mood and mindset of aspiring civil servants. G-Files today is a must read for every civil servant. Our readers, all bureaucrats, central ministers, governors and chief ministers, members of parliament, embassies, CEOs of top corporate houses, our stars. Our contributors include former cabinet secretary Prabhat Kumar, former chief secretary Delhi Shailja Chandra, former secretary Raw AK Verma, former secretary education MK Kao, former chairman CBDT TN Pandey, and former IFS. journalism with a difference. Our USP includes exclusive news and views straight from the horse's mouth, inside view of the political and administrative arena, interviews, case studies, profiles, birthdays, financial planning tips, and much, much more. Buzz on the recent promotions, postings, extension, and retirement. Content you wouldn't find anywhere else in the print, electronic, or web media. Our reach, print magazine, G-Files magazine, is available in 156 niche newsstands across the country and is read cover to cover by more than 2 lakh people. The reach of G-Files includes all governors, central and state ministers, chief ministers and members of parliament, all secretaries, additional secretaries, joint secretaries to the government of India, chief secretaries, DMs, collectors, divisional commissioners, SSPs and DIGs in the states, judges, prosecutors and law officers in the Supreme Court, High Court and District Courts, embassies, consulates and foreign missions and all Indian embassies and missions abroad, all IAS, IFS, IPS, IRS, Customs, Central Excise, Armed Forces, paramilitary forces like BSF, CRPF, Railway, Postal Services, Audits and Account Service personnel as well. All central and state civil services like Indian Defence Account Service, Indian Information Service, Indian Defence Estate Services and Central Industrial Security Force, academic and management institutes of repute, all prominent hotels and hospitals, administrators in all 629 districts, banks and financial institutions, public sector undertakings and the entire media. Online version, gfilesindia.com, is visited by over 21 lakh netizens in India and abroad. Readership profile, it's a magazine of the bureaucrats by the bureaucrats. The readers include 65% of males, 35% females. Of these, 42% are in the 35 to 45 age group, 31% are in the 45 to 55 age group, and 22% are in the 25 to 35 age group. This is just the beginning. Be a winner with the G-Files, a medium to communicate directly with the government and bureaucracy. Catch the attention of people with power to approve, reject or sanction anything. An ideal medium to network and consolidate your brand image in the government. Has a high shelf life. It pays to advertise. Advertising in G-Files. Bureaucrats make excellent brand ambassadors, showcasing your brand directly in the homes and offices of people who matter. Money well spent, as the government is a bulk buyer of many goods and services and spends more than 5 lakh crore rupees every year. Our advertisers include Air India, Boeing, Swatch, U.com, Spring Travels, OMGC, Indian Oil, SAIL, Hindustan Petroleum, Tata Sky, NTPC, SBI, BHEL, GAIL, PFC, NHPC, Government of Haryana, Government of Rajasthan, Ministry of Tourism, Tamil Nadu Tourism, Karnataka Tourism, Goa Tourism, Via Talks, MP Tourism. There are endless possibilities where G-Files is concerned. Come, let's explore it. G-Files, G-Files, G-Files.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, for the first time in the history of India, welcome to the G-Files Governance Awards 2012. Without wasting any more time, ladies and gentlemen, let's move the protocol ahead for the evening. May I request a few gentlemen to kindly come forward and present a shawl and a bouquet to our very esteemed chief guest and guest of honors to welcome them formally into the Governance Awards function. So there we are. May I request Mr. Rakesh Bharadwaj and Mr. M.S. Anand, directors of Sarva Shrestha Media, to kindly come on stage, please. And some music to go with the wonderful evening. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Rakesh Bharadwaj and Mr. M.S. Anand. Thank you very much for the wonderful support of few people without whom this evening would not have been possible. And I would like to request Mr. Bharadwaj and Mr. Anand to heartily welcome our chief guest, Minister External Affairs, Mr. Salman Khurshid, on stage and welcome him with a shawl and a bouquet. Sir, your presence, as always, is very highly respected. A big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much, Honorable Minister, Mr. Salman Khurshid. May I now request Mr. Ajay Jha, a very well-known political editor, and now the political editor of G-Files, to kindly come on stage, please. Mr. Ajay Jha. Mr. Jha is known to be a real grinder in the media world. May I request the chairman of NTPC, Mr. Arup Roy Chaudhary, to kindly join us on stage for a small presentation, please. He has not come in, so I would request Mr. Ajay Jha to be on stage as we move ahead. May I request Mr. R.M. Malla sir to kindly come on stage and receive the honor, please. Mr. R.M. Malla sir. A big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. A few gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen, are on their way, so excuse me if you're just changing a protocol for a little bit, so I would request Mr. Tyagi to help me out with this. May I request Mr. Naresh Minocha, Associate Editor of G-Files, to kindly join us on stage, and the presentation shall go to our next guest of honor who's present here. And Mr. T.R. Ramachandran from G-Files, Executive Editor of G-Files, if you could kindly join us on stage. And if they are not here, I would request Mr. Anil Tyagi to do the honors, please. And are they here? Because I'm helpless now. Big functions require a lot of coordination, ladies and gentlemen. So please excuse us for a bit of a change. Sir, please. And may I request Chairman ONGC, he's also on the way. All right. Chairman of EPI, Sir, Mr. S.P.S. Bakshi, to kindly step forward, please. Ladies and gentlemen, a big round of applause of welcome to Mr. S.P.S. Bakshi, sir. Thank you so much, sir, Mr. Bakshi. Now, ladies and gentlemen, the Governance Awards has been backed by a whole lot of homework and has been specially monitored by a team of jury members who themselves have immense amount of experience, excellence, and credibility in governance over the sands of time. I would request our Honorable Minister, Mr. Salman Khurshid, to again, because his dynamic presence in any function is always very highly motivating, to kindly come forward and bless the occasion by felicitating our jury members. Sir, Mr. Salman Khurshid. A big round of applause at the back. And just a bit of humor, Baba Ramdev says that if you clap for the others, you get spiritual energy. So ladies and gentlemen, I'm sure we all are in search of spiritual energy. So please do us that honor. Sir, thank you so much. Our first jury member, ladies and gentlemen, is a 1963 batch UP Cadre IS officer. His dynamic presence has been with more than 40 years of rich and varied experience at various levels of governance, from the grassroots level in the state to the highest level at the center. He was the Cabinet Secretary of India during the Prime Ministership of Mr. Atal Bihari Vajpayee. Thereafter, he served as Governor of the tribal state of Jharkhand. Please welcome Mr. Prabhat Kumar. It's a great honor, ladies and gentlemen, to have our Honorable Minister with us. And he has always been very encouraging and supportive in motivating people. Sir, our next jury member for the Governance Awards is a 1965 batch Haryana Cadre IS officer. He has held important positions in the state as well as the central government. And amongst the positions held by him include Excise and Taxation Commissioner, Deputy Commissioner Sonipat and Faridabad, Principal Secretary to the Chief Minister, Mr. Om Prakash Chautala, and later Chief Secretary of Haryana. He was India's representative to the Food and Agricultural Organization of the UNO at Rome. Please welcome Mr. Vishnu Bhagwan. Thank you, jury members, for taking the time out and lending us your vast experience for making the Governance Awards truly credible and absolutely neutral in terms of decision making. Honorable Minister, ladies and gentlemen, our next jury member is a physics graduate from St. Stephen's College. If I'm not mistaken, our Honorable Minister also hails from the same college, and so do I, much junior. It gives us a lot of pride to be in the same esteemed gathering. And a law graduate from Delhi University's law faculty. He joined the IAS in the 1973 Haryana cadre, and after initial stints in Haryana, moved to the central government as additional and special secretary in the Ministry of Petroleum before taking over as secretary Ministry of Power. Highly respected as a visionary and a man behind many path-breaking initiatives in the power sector, he is today one of India's most eminent energy experts, strategic advisor, and consultant in the field of energy. Please welcome our next jury, Mr. Anil Rajdan. A very proud moment here, ladies and gentlemen. Honorable Minister, our next jury member is an IPS officer of the 1963 batch, served as secretary in the Home Ministry on Internal Security, Police and Department of Jammu and Kashmir, a recipient of the Indian Police Medal for Meritorious Service and the President of India's Police Medal for Distinguished Service. During his illustrious service, he also served as Director General of Central Reserve Police Force and the Police Commissioner of Delhi. Please welcome the very esteemed Mr. M.B. Kaushal. And finally, ladies and gentlemen, a man of the corporate sector. He was conferred the Microfinance Indian Sector 2012 Award, a Lifetime Achievement Award to honor long-term significant contribution of an individual to the issues of the microfinance sector. Earlier as CMD of SIDBI, he was instrumental in guiding it to become the largest microfinance lender in the world. Subsequently, under his leadership as CMD, IDBI Bank has joined the league of the few banks that are lending to the microfinance sector in India. Honorable Minister, with your permission, let me welcome Mr. RM Malla on stage. Thank you so much. Thank you, Honorable Minister. We shall require your presence a little while later to give away the awards. Ladies and gentlemen, hope you are all happy. And a wonderful historic occasion this. May I request the wonderful man behind the Governess Awards, one of the visionaries, and a gentleman with whom I have shared the camera in front of a few television channels many a times, Mr. Anil Tyagi, for his welcome address.
Namaskar. Honorable Chairman, Honorable Shri Salman Khurshid Sahib, Minister of External Affairs, Government of India, Honorable Jury Members, Honorable Awardees, the Chairman of the Public Sector Undertakings, and my dear distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. I welcome you on this great occasion on the completion of 5 years of G-Files, a mission started with meager resources. I can't tell you in detail when we started this magazine, what was in our mind, and because we have been reporter through all our life, so we didn't know the business part of that. And Salman bhai can understand, reporter turns the entrepreneur and the editor and the publisher, how difficult it is. So this is the first ever governance award ceremony and the fifth anniversary of G-Files. Last year we had our first governance summit on the challenges of governance. We are still in that mindset. This year we discussed and decided that in this atmosphere of expose and scams, we are missing those heroes in the country who are running the growth engine of the nation. The 120 crore population of the country is managed and served by only 2.75 crore government servants. This is amazing. Nowhere in the world is the government population ratio is so low. Across the world, even in the most developed countries, the government servants to population ratio are around 5 to 6%. In the given circumstances, one can understand the work pressure the present government setup may be facing, especially seen in context with the rising aspirations of the people in view of the globalized character of the economy. We claim that we are very much organized, as well as if you see and analyze what is happening in the government, we claim that we are organized, but within the system knows well that how difficult it has become to not only work but ensure the delivery of various governmental schemes and measures to ameliorate the condition of the poorest of the poor and make the common man feel that government cares for him. The general perception about the bureaucracy of India in good old days was that the steel frame of India is not penetrable by the vested interests. However, the rapid changes in the economy and compulsions of coalition politics have resulted into vested interests making deep roads into the system and has been causing the decision making to be either subverted in their favor at the cost of the general good of the public at large, or practically no decisions or actions being taken. I will just go off the track from the writing thing. For last 5 years I am covering especially the bureaucracy myself, and I can feel the pain of the, especially the on the undersecretary level, the director level, when the decisions are being taken. And our cover story, particularly this time, we have knowingly put that cover story because our young leader Rahul Gandhi says that he will even minimize the gap between the decision and the file to reach up to the decision is 15 days. We have analyzed all people who are there. They must read this, particularly this cover story, how difficult it is to take the decision within 15 days to 20 days and finalize and formalize the decision up to the implementation stage. Prabhat Kumar ji knows, I have been regularly discussing with him how the joint secretary level officers are stressed. Every project and most of the ministries whose quantum has increased up to 1 lakh crore to 2 lakh crore rupees decisions, number one, the system is not available there, the technical know-how is not available there, and the pressure to take the decision is much more on that middle rank officers rather than the high rank officers. It is a really, really, my kudos to the bureaucracy, how they are facing this crisis, I do not know. It is a really painful situation. Let me go ahead. Bureaucrats by training are shy or an introvert society. However, there are thousands of them who are very efficient, dynamic and vibrant or result-oriented, working not only in the cities but in far-flung areas. They seldom beat their drums about their achievements. Honorable Prime Minister Dr. Manmohan Singh was the first to realize the need to pat the backroom boys of the Government of India and introduce the concept of awarding bureaucrats who had done commendable work to significantly improve the standards of public life. Dr. Singh launched PM's Award for Good Governance in the year 2007, and every year, 21st April is celebrated as Civil Services Day. It was a noble idea. Dr. Manmohan Singh should be applauded for sincere and committed efforts to recognize and appreciate his fellow army of the implementers of his ideas. I must say, we must clap for his wonderful decisions. In the last more than 5 years, we have published a series of good work done by the bureaucrats across the country in our magazine. We call that column, under which we publish this achievements of the different bureaucrats, is called the milestone. But we firmly believe, and you will also appreciate, that good work, wherever done, should not only be written about, but should be widely appreciated and applauded within and outside the domain of the government. Keeping this idea in mind, GFILE's governance awards were conceptualized. Since the widely prevalent perception about the media is to criticize and expose only, the concept was first discussed by me and Dr. Sood with the jury chairman, Honorable Shri Prabhat Kumar ji. And frankly speaking, when we were planning Salman Bhai, we didn't know how that will shape up, how it will come. And we were apprehending the bureaucrats will accept this award or not, because they have to take so many permissions. Again, the file moves to take the permission to get the award. So that is the thing. There were many constraints, but with the efforts of Prabhat Kumar ji, Rajdan Sahab, Vishnu Bhagwan ji, MB Kaushal Sahab and Raram Malla Sahab, we could formally launch the awards and decided to confine it to the outstanding contribution made by civil servants only. I am very thankful to the jury for all their support and guidance in the days to come. GFILES will work to institutionalize these awards and widen its scope substantially to include other notable areas of public life. We welcome the criticism and suggestions from all of you so that the same can be assimilated to make these awards more inclusive and popular. The award function will unfold before you very shortly. Before I move further, I am thankful to Honorable Minister Shri Salman Khurshid Saab, who has accepted my invitation at a very short notice. When I called Salman Bhai on phone, one can't believe, because I am just telling you the perceptive change in the government. We contacted many ministers, say around maybe around 20, and most of the ministers replied very promptly within hours. Even Chidambaram Saab, within by 5 minutes to 7 minutes. When I called Salman Bhai that this is a program is going on, he said, 22nd, I am free, you just check my office, I am available. and it is done. He has come. I am meeting after a very long time, Salman bhai, around 6 months or 7 months. Your presence shows that all of you who have come here and who are present, I believe that you are a votary and wish to appreciate and applaud the good work done by some of our finest public servants who worked out of the box ideas to make a decisive change in the life of people they served. I once again thank you all, and I am especially thankful to our awardees who has come here on a very short notice and have accepted our awards, and I welcome you all again, and thanks a lot.
Thank you so much. A welcome address from the heart, Mr. Anil Tyagi. Ladies and gentlemen, as Mr. Tyagi said, tonight is a celebration of governance. Tonight is the beginning, a very humble beginning of G-Files to take this into the next level of cutting across all lines and bringing the government more closer to the people and focusing on the wonderful, excellent work over decades done by wonderful people holding positions of power. To take the program forward, I would like to request the man who's chairing the jury who has decided on the awards here tonight. As Mr. Tyagi said, this was not easy, and this is history. This is the first time that such an award function is being held anywhere in the country. So, sir, Mr. Prabhat Kumar, if you could kindly come forward and share your views about the thought and the process that went into the governance awards. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Prabhat Kumar.
Salman Khurshid ji, distinguished guests of honor, members of the jury, the award winners, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of the members of the jury, I wish to compliment G-Files for honoring civil servants for outstanding work in public service. It's a curious fact that while the misdemeanors, indiscretions, and follies of civil servants find their due mention in the media, in the mainstream media, nobody talks about the good work that is being done by many of them inconspicuously. That is why I think this is a very laudable effort of G-Files to have instituted these awards. If we see the mainstream media, there are stories and stories. Even today there is a story of civil servants not doing their job properly. But there's hardly any media group or a media outfit that has reported the achievements of civil servants, not in the secretariat, but in the field. And that is why I congratulate G-Files, I congratulate the civil servants who are being honored today. But let me hasten to add that they are not the only ones worthy of such recognition. There are hundreds, maybe thousands more, who are equally, if not more, deserving of such recognition. In fact, it was very difficult for the jury to pick and choose among the cases which were brought before us. People know about the innovative creativity of some of our stalwarts, like Mr. T. N. Session, E. Sridharan, R. S. Pandey, and others. They also perhaps know about the lifetime achievements of people like Julio Ribeiro and Krishna Swami Rao Sahib. But how many of us know about the silent work which is being done by civil servants who raise the bar of their performance much above the call of duty? They do not find any mention in the dispatches. How many of us know about a forest fire alert and messaging scheme which has been recently started in Madhya Pradesh? It's satellite based. How many of us know about the Aarogya Shri experiment in Andhra Pradesh or the Sanjeevani scheme of Gujarat? Or the tax return preparer scheme, which has